and welcome to the Cityline Book Club. We're here today to talk about The Confabulist by Stephen Galloway. And since we have a lot to talk about, we'll get right into it.
We will.
So what I wanted to ask you guys first was just a bit about the characters, what you guys thought about them. Was there anyone you really liked? And if so, why? I mean, I was captivated by Harry Houdini. That was what sold me on the book in the first place. And, you know, I like the idea of taking a historical character and then just going wild with him. I mean, he basically becomes a spy in the novel, a double agent at times. And I thought that was super cool. But I was wondering what else you guys thought about the characters.
Are you looking at me?
Yeah.
Okay, let them answer first. I'm going to say about Harry Houdini, that man really gave me a heart attack. Oh my gosh, holy MacGyver. He got out of every single situation, and he is put in so many crazy situations in this book. I thought he was so intelligent. My stress level was through the roof on his behalf. I would not want to be in his position at all, but I was completely captivated. I wanted to hear about his story from beginning to end. I also agree. I think it's so cool when an author can take a historical situation and then write a fiction around it. So Harry Houdini went from sort of not really a big deal to me to, wow, that guy was smart. I really liked him. He was my favorite. Martin Strauss kind of drove me a little bit nuts. Like, his story was a little bit, he was filled with so much angst that I thought was not necessary. So I will say I was frustrated with Martin Strauss, but absolutely loved Harry Houdini.
I really liked Harry Houdini. Again, I like the way that they took a well-known character and put him in such bizarre, different circumstances. And the whole idea, is it true? Is it not? Is it a made-up memory? Is it true? It just actually, it made me want to go back and look into Harry Houdini, his real life, and find out a little bit more about, okay, maybe what was true in the book? What was the fake? What was the false memories, not the fake, the false memories? But it was so interesting to use that type of a historical figure that way.
I really like the part where Houdini was, he'd always say, it's not magic. I am just, you know, faking you out, really. I mean, it's all real, and this is not, and I love that, and I love the tricks that he used, like that whole thing with the false penis. Oh my goodness. Wasn't that interesting? Like, who knew? Of course they would have known. I know. You got to read that part. Anyway, and then the false finger and all the little tricks he did and the fact that he could hold his breath for so long. Have you tried to hold your breath that long? I mean, like, that's how come he could do all these. So he was so, you know, people go, I don't think people understand how much talent is involved in doing that kind of stuff. I mean, couldn't he tie things with his toes?
Yes.
Like, I mean, that, what a lot of practice. And you go, I quit, you know, so you could be Harry Houdini too if you'd practice that long. What is it? How did you get to Carnegie Hall? Practice, practice, practice? Yeah.
100,000 hours, right?
10,000 hours.
You do it long enough, you could be Harry Houdini.
There you go.
Maybe. I mean, he was an ordinary guy. And I found that really interesting, too, the whole idea that he really created Harry Houdini. He was just Eric Weiss. He was just a regular guy, but he created this personality and then everything that came along with it.
He was marketing before social media and all that kind of thing. I mean, he was like, could you imagine what he'd be now? Who's the biggest magician now?
David Copperfield.
Because he makes things disappear. Yeah. Not really. Smoke and mirrors, man.
All smoke and mirrors. So from that, and Carolyn, you kind of touched on this, but the other thing I liked in the book, there's my card. I like just the whole idea of memories and false memories and, you know, I mean, obviously with Martin Strauss, he's actually fabricating these memories, but even the idea that even you or I don't necessarily remember everything as it happened in life. We kind of, whether we want to or not, we do kind of mess with our own memories. And I thought that was really interesting. And I was just wondering if you guys had any thoughts on that in your own life. It got me thinking about my own memories personally. Yes, Tracy Moore?
me. Okay, thanks to social media, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and blogs, I don't think there will be a moment that we will be able to forget now. I think that memory is being altered by the capturing of images second by second in our lives. And I often wonder,
how things are going to be for my kids who have had all of their moments captured from the time they were born versus us. We've got some foggy photos from the 70s, and so many of our events actually have to remain in our brain. This is where they have to live because we don't have photographic evidence of it. So the question of memory to me, it's an evolutionary thing based on what's happening in society. And in the book, I thought that was cool that they played with that idea of memory. And you get drawn down that road. You go down that road of, is this real or is this not? Because when you read the book, you'll find that he actually has an actual problem with memory. So anyways, something to think about.
But I think we all do that. There's so many memories that, you know, I have such an point of view on, and then I talked to my siblings who were there, and theirs is completely different. It's like, we were in the same situation. How could your memory of that whole event be so different from mine? And it's very interesting that you mentioned the photographs, because a couple of weeks ago we were looking through old photographs with my kids. So I've got all their baby pictures and toddler pictures, and then there's nothing. Yeah. Everything is on the computer. But we had a stack of pictures, and they love to go through them and and do you remember this time? And do you remember this time? Mm-hmm. And it is that idea. Oh, I remember that time. I remember you were awful, but I didn't say that. You're driving me nuts. I didn't say that.
I think you guys brought a really good point about the memory thing and the false memory, but I like the POV, like when you said, like, your siblings have a different recollection of it, and I love the POV, like, you know, your point of view, like, and it's like I say sometimes, you know, I said something, but my son heard this, or my mom and dad said something, and I heard this instead, so your filtering system, and so I thought that was neat, and I actually believe that he didn't have false memories. I think they were all real, but that's just how I was reading it. You know, so, and it's because I wanted it to be real, you know? And so, I don't know. And I think that was the magical part of the book, was that I know they were saying these are false memories. Like, they set it right up. And I was going, liar! Liar!
No. But they were real to him.
Yeah.
But that's the interesting part of it. It was all real to him. That's what I found to be so interesting.
But it was real to me, too. So maybe I'm just, you know, like...
Crazy.
Yeah, okay, we're going to go with I'm crazy.
Or that you fell under the magic of the novel, you know? You fell under the magic of the story.
Yeah.
Because, you know, it was all magic. No,
I'm going with I'm crazy.
You're just crazy. Marilyn's a little crazy. All right, well, anyways, speaking of his false memories and such, tiny spoiler alert, we just want to... talk a little bit about the ending, and not so much about what was revealed, because there were some big reveals there that we'll leave out of the discussion, but okay, whether we were all satisfied with those reveals, if we were okay with the twists and turns and the fact that we were told one thing and then at the end told kind of something completely different. And did you feel misled? Were you cool with what happened in the end? What do you think?
Leading the witness.
Totally leading the witness.
Okay, spoiler alert, they all die. No, I just wanted to say that. It's not true.
I found it was a very interesting ending, because you basically went on the journey one way, and to not completely turn you around, but that, oh, okay. But I noticed that, and we were talking about this earlier, the beginning of the book, I would flip because they'd have dates for the chapters. And even at the beginning, I was like, wait, I have to go back. I'm not really sure. So I kind of foresaw some of what was happening. And yeah, I actually found it was interesting. I like twists. I like things that kind of get me to go, oh, that's interesting.
Yeah, I get actually upset about that stuff. I don't like it. I feel like, you know what, I want my money back. This wasn't what I was sold, which probably says volumes about me. But when I got to the end of this, the fact that it left me with questions, I was okay with it because I was happy enough to be taken down this journey. I enjoyed the adventure so much that I was okay with the fact that I had to tie up some of my own loose ends. I had to do a bit of work at the end. And I was okay with that. I like the questions that came out at the end. And I like the fact that we all have a different perspective, because that is what literature is about. It's a puzzle. You can come up with the solution in your mind. You can create your own art, you can create your own adventure, and so I thought that was great. I loved it.
Well said. totally agree.
I do too.
I mean, I think just having a book that we can all have such strong different views on is really cool. So thank you, Stephen, for writing a book that had that for us.
And I want to make an elephant disappear.
Okay, we'll work on that. Stay tuned for that. So on that note, while Marilyn makes an elephant disappear, if you've been reading along with us on The Confabulist, we'd love to hear what you thought about it. And if you share a comment in the post below this video, you'll be entered to win a lovely prize pack from Random House Canada. So read along, leave a comment, let us know what you think, and we'll see you next time. Thanks so much.